Built into Home Assistant is the CO2 signal integration, which grabs the current grid carbon intensity for your country to use in Home Assistant. You can use this data to view how much of the energy that you drew from the grid was low carbon or green. But if you live in the UK, then the value from CO2 signal is an average over the whole of the UK and not very accurate for your specific location. So here's a way to get your local regional grid carbon intensity data. The problem with CO2 signal in the UK is that carbon intensity can vary dramatically across the country. If you're up in Scotland, then a lot of the time you're running fully on renewables such as wind and hydro, but down in South Wales there's almost always a significant generation from gas. If you take a look at electricitymaps.com, where CO2 signal gets its data from, you can see that the whole country is one averaged value. But the National Grid ESO actually breaks down the UK into 14 regions, and you can browse a breakdown of current generation data for each one of those regions using the ESO app. But more importantly, the ESO make that data available via a public API. Yes, you can query their API for free, and they'll provide you with data on things like the carbon intensity of current and historical time periods and the mix of generation such as solar, gas, coal, nuclear and so on. I will put a link to the API documentation in the description, but the data we're interested in here is the regional carbon intensity data. You can feed the API your postcode and it will send you a full breakdown of the current generation and carbon intensity in one go. Of course, to use this in Home Assistant, you'll need to do a bit of work first. I go over this in most of my videos, but you will need a way to edit your configuration files. I suggest installing the File Editor add-on by going to Settings, Add-ons, down to the Add-on Store button, and then you can find File Editor in that list and click on Install. This will take a couple of minutes, so I'm going to speed it up and see you once it's finished. Okay, once it's installed, toggle the little switch that says Show in Sidebar and click on Start. Should take a couple of seconds to start, and then you should see over on the left hand side File Editor. So click on that, and by default it should open up your configuration YAML file. If it doesn't, just click on this little button at the top, scroll down to find configuration YAML and click on it there. Scroll down the file to the bottom, find an empty space and paste in this configuration. Now you'll find this configuration on my website and I'll put a link to that in the description. Now once you've pasted it in, before you save it, you'll need to edit the resource URL. That's this line right here. Specifically, what you need to change are these characters here. Now this is the first half of your postcode. I've used the BBC W1A postcode in London just as an example here. Once you've changed that, save the configuration, drop down to Developer Tools, check to make sure there's no errors, and restart Home Assistant to apply the changes. Once it's rebooted, we're going to check to make sure that it's all worked. So we'll go down to Settings, Devices and Services, Entities, and we'll filter here by Carbon. You should see three different entities. This one in the middle is the fossil fuel percentage. This is the percentage of the current generation that comes from fossil fuels. You can use this entity in something like the PowerFlow Card Plus to display the low carbon energy flows. This second one is the green fuel percentage. This is the percentage of the current generation that comes only from green sources such as solar, wind, and hydro. And the last one at the top is the actual grid carbon intensity value for your local area, and it's measured in grams of CO2 per kilowatt hour. I think it's important to be aware of how green the energy is that you are using, and being able to see a more accurate value is handy if you're automating things such as charging your car or home battery based on how clean your imported energy is. To help with that visibility, you can create a gauge on your dashboard to show you that at a glance. The ESO have defined certain bands of carbon intensity from very low right the way up to very high, and these bands change every year. This is from the ESO's carbon intensity forecast methodology document, and you can see that for 2023 the band very low is defined as carbon intensity of 0 to 39 and so on. Make a note of those values. Edit your dashboard and add a card, and we're going to add a card of type gauge. Going to look for the entity called Carbon Intensity Regional, this one here. Going to give it a name of Grid Carbon Intensity. intensity. I'm going to set the maximum value to 600 and I want to display it as a needle gauge. And I also do want to add some segments to this to make it a little bit more interesting. But in order to do that, I'm actually going to do it in the code editor. So if I switch to the code editor, I'm going to add in the segments. Oh, I don't want to max. And you can see I've defined several segments and they're all based on the bands that are defined by the ESO, apart from these last two. And I thought we needed a red and a dark red just to make it look a little bit more dramatic. Click on save and done, and you have your very own local grid carbon intensity gauge on your dashboard. Anyway, I hope you find this useful, and don't forget to check out my website with all of the configuration there for you to copy and paste. Please give this video a like and subscribe to my channel to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.